Yeah, Mark, you're gonna be critical, and I'll take a phone dinner.
I asked them all that, you know. I asked them who needs to do the lower thirds and all that kind of stuff.
The lower third will be a problem.
Why?
Because this machine, this swim studio, whatever the equipment you can put it to it, yes. You can't get to line it up. That's why you don't get to the general point to line up.
45 seconds. Ready? Never back for me. Seconds to opener.
We note that any views expressed on Cayman Crosstalk do not necessarily reflect or represent the views of Compass Media, its staff, or contributors. Individuals who choose to call or comment do so at their own risk and should ensure that they comply with all laws and regulations, including those relating to defamation and privacy. Have your say on 233-1019, WhatsApp message 324-1019, or find us on Facebook at Cayman Crosstalk. This is Cayman Crosstalk on Rooster 101, leading Cayman Band's conversation.
Omen of soft, fresh breezes and budding trees so fair, with thy creator's glory reflected everywhere. O sea of palest emerald, merging to darkest blue, whene'er my thoughts fly Godward, I always think of you. Dear verdant island set in blue Caribbean Sea, I'm coming very soon. Shrines thee yet, homeland fair Cayman Isle. I cannot thee forget.
Good morning, Cayman. This is Chanda V, your host for Cayman Crosstalk. All right, it's Thursday. It's a wet one, guys, so make sure you're taking your time coming down this morning as you prepare to go to work. And thanks for hanging out with us. So we are going to get you caught up on the news because there's a lot happening. We just had our press conference yesterday, so we now have new reopening dates. So you're going to hear a little bit about that, as well as we have some severe weather alerts. We're going to be talking about all of that when we come back, as well as having some context of what happened in our last tropical storm. We have Darren Zucker and Chef Afzal from Holiday Inn coming in to talk about how they served up some grace to their guests during and after Tropical Storm Grace. And then we'll also have PC Powery coming in to talk about personal safety and road safety as we go back to school, and as well as, you know, some of the personal attacks and assaults that have been taking place. So all of that coming up. But first, some news, and we'll be right back with more Crosstalk.
Good morning, this is Tim Hartman for Compass Media. Here are your top news headlines for Thursday, the 26th of August. Forecasters say a tropical wave sweeping through the Caribbean south of Cayman could develop into a tropical depression or storm, most likely by tomorrow. Cayman Islands National Weather Service warned the system is expected to produce significant rainfall across the Cayman Islands, 1 to 2 inches expected, with flooding most likely to occur on Friday. In a severe weather bulletin issued by the National Weather Service yesterday, forecasters said whether or not the system develops into a tropical depression or stronger, Cayman could expect cloudy and overcast skies, scattered thunderstorms with showers likely to be heavy at times over the next 48 hours. And the Cayman Islands government has revised the date for when it hopes the islands will reach the 80% vaccination rate from the 9th of September to the 14th of October. With the original target date just 2 weeks away, the fully vaccinated rate in Cayman is currently at 69%, a rate that has not increased since the 13th of August. The government's original reopening plan, announced by Premier Wayne Panton in early July, involved a limited return of tourism by the 9th of September when Phase 3 of the plan gets underway, contingent on reaching the 80% goal. Panton, speaking at a press briefing yesterday, said Phase 3 will go ahead as planned, even without reaching the 80% target. He pointed out that when quarantine restrictions for vaccinated tourists are lifted on the 14th of October, Phase 4 of the plan, the risk of community transmission in Cayman will rise exponentially. So to be clear, that next phase will go ahead whether or not we have reached those vaccination numbers. HSA.ky has the latest vaccination schedule. Make sure you're following Hazard Management, the Cayman Islands National Weather Service, also gov.ky for all the updated weather information over the next 24 hours. And for these and other of the nation's news headlines, visit caymancompass.com.
Cayman Crosstalk is leading Cayman's conversation. Be a part of the conversation now. Call 233-1019.
All right, everybody, welcome back. So, we're in it. We're in it to win it. It's Thursday, and I know, like I said, it's a little bit gloomy. You heard it in the news that we have these systems still around us, and we're going to have to watch out because we have those severe weather threats coming through. So, just if you haven't... if you haven't been paying attention, and if you haven't been just waking up and realize it's wet outside, it's very wet. So I just want to remind you guys and caution you guys to be, you know, as prepared as you possibly can, because this isn't weather we need to be messing with. And in a few minutes, I'll bring in Darren Zucker, the food and beverage manager from Holiday Inn, as well as Chef Afzal. And they're going to take us through their experience, because I know it's been different for everybody. And some people didn't have any damage. Some people were just kind of like, you know, the power went out, the power came back on. It was wet outside. Maybe a few trees fell. But other than that, they might not have had any major impact. And it was funny because when we were cleaning up and we had flooding, we had people calling my mom's business, and you know, they're like, and this was just a prime example to me, like of my firsthand thing, where I'm here, you know, in dirty water trying to get my house in order, and people are calling for business services the very next day, and I'm like, wait a minute, hold on, pause. And it was just a very big eye opener as to, you know, some people really weren't impacted at all by Tropical Storm Grace, whereas others were under these severe conditions. And, you know, I had other business owners telling me that, you know, they had clients calling them asking for, you know, their services, and, you know, just like business as usual. And she's like, hold on. Again, like, we just had a very major storm. So, you know, we had a Carrie Powery in here from National Weather Service telling us about this. You know, like the gusts were almost Category 2. So that's why there's this whole debate. Was it a hurricane? Was it a tropical storm? This wasn't a normal tropical storm. And I don't know how many times we can impress upon the public that just because it's a tropical storm or less than a Category 1 doesn't mean it can't be serious weather. Also heard about people in one of the chat groups on Facebook that, you know, people were saying that pots and beach chairs and those kind of things were just left out and not secured. And then, you know, we saw pictures of, like, lawn chairs flying into people's windows and all kind of stuff. So, I mean, not necessarily breaking them, but it was scary outside. And those things, you know, we normally should take up. But because in our minds, it's not that big of a deal, then when the weather system turns and when it gets, you know, dangerous out there, those things then become projectiles. And we haven't thought it all the way through. So storm prep is storm prep. From here on out, storm prep means you get prepared, because even if it's a tropical storm, it could turn into a Category 2. So that's how we have to deal with this. So there's some severe weather bulletins that the Cayman Islands National Weather Service has provided. So there's a flood warning, and this came out yesterday. And, you know, so we just want to make sure that people know that it's going to be wet for the next couple of days. They're looking at maybe 1 to 2 inches of rainfall expected between Thursday night and Friday night. And also there's a marine warning because wave heights are going to be 4 to 6 feet today. And then Friday they're looking like 6 to 8 feet and Saturday 5 to 7 feet. So throughout today, tomorrow, into Saturday, we need to be very cautious, making sure, you know, our grounds, we've had a little bit of sunshine for the last week, thankfully, and our grounds are just starting to dry out, so hopefully we won't have like that severe flooding inside our homes, but we still have to be prepared that yards may be flooded and there may be what's the word I'm looking for? Inconveniences out there as well. And just when we're still recovering from this whole situation with Tropical Storm Grace. So anyway, I want to do a giveaway because, as you know, we have our sponsors at Walk and Roll who are so generous and they give us tons of gift certificates to give away for meals there. So I want to do some giveaways and it's going to be all about are you prepared, because we have tropical storm weather. We have, you know, like this is our season, hurricane season. So we're going to have lots of stormy weather, severe weather alerts that we need to prepare for. We just had the reopening announcements changed a little bit. So we need to prepare for that. The new date is the 14th of October. That's the date the premier has said. You need a date. That's the date, right? So if you haven't got your vaccine, I'm not going to say if you haven't got it, and like some people can't get it, I understand that. If you've been wanting to get the vaccine, if you know you need to get it, if you're that person that's just been like, I'll do it tomorrow, then you need to do it today. You need to do it tomorrow for real. You need to get that done. Because remember, it's going to also take 2 weeks from the second shot for you to be able to be fully vaccinated, considered fully vaccinated and protected as much as a vaccine can protect you. So I know, guys, there's so much information out there, and that was a big part of the press conference as well. But we'll get into all of that later into the show, and I want to dedicate some time tomorrow morning to go through this in more detail. But as far as the giveaway, like I said, we have the weather to prepare for. We have COVID reopenings to prepare for. We also have back to school to prepare for. So I want you guys to give me a call. Tell me what you are prepared for. I know people are on WhatsApp, and I know you guys are. I'm hanging over at the Crosstalk Facebook page. But what I would like is for you to call me on 233-1019. That is 233-1019. Just a quick phone call. Tell me what you are prepared for. All right. So whether it's back to school, border reopenings, the weather, tell me what you're prepared for, how you're prepared for it, and you're going to win a gift certificate. I'm probably going to give away more than one. So, and again, I notice you guys haven't been calling in for the giveaways because you probably think, oh, somebody else will do it. If that's you and you're thinking, I should call. I want to talk to you. All right, guys. So, as I said, big shout out to our sponsors at Walk and Roll. And we also have Yellow, who keep us streaming over there on the Crosstalk Facebook page, as well as the Cayman Compass YouTube channel. So if you want to send messages, let me know. Let me know that you're listening. Let me know how your day's going. And, you know, let me know that you're prepared as well. I still want to know, but I want you to call me to win the Walk and Roll gift certificates. So also have some birthdays I want to shout out today, too. So Carolyn, she's been here on the show. Amazing poet. You know, she's a literary I don't want to say guru, I don't know what the right word is, but she's passionate about literature. So you'll see her, she's on books of Instagram, bookagram, I don't know what they call it over there on Instagram, but if there's a book talk, she's probably on that too. So just a big shout out to her and a happy birthday. If you haven't checked out the episode that we read her poetry out on, it was fantastic. Amazing. Also, Fame, a big shout out to you too, and happy birthday. So I hope you guys have a safe birthday day today with all this weather. Please watch out, be careful on the road, and enjoy your weekend as well. And anyone else who is having a birthday, all my Virgos out there, fellow earth signs, enjoy your birthday this week. So let's see, what else do we got going on? Still waiting for y'all to call in. Don't forget, it's 233-1019. We had some back to school stuff. All right. So, yeah, we got to prepare to go back to school. And we're going to have PC Powery coming in around 8 o'clock. And she's from the RCIPS. She's their media relations officer. And we love Jody. We love Jody on here. We're always a pleasure to have her on. She's going to just take us through some of the back-to-school safety tips. All right. We have a caller. Hi. Good morning, caller. You're live on Crosstalk. Nope. All right. Call back. Call back. You could be a winner. All right. So, as I was saying, we're going to have PC Powery coming in because there's been a lot of concerns around road safety, and we've seen that. We've had lots of accidents this year. It's been coming up. There's a lot of road safety stuff that we need to discuss, and we have a caller. Hello, caller. You're live on Crosstalk. Hello?
Yes, good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
Good, thank you.
All right. So, what are you prepared for?
I prepare for the grand opening on the October 14th
uh-huh.
with my two vaccines.
You got your two vaccines and you're prepared for the reopening?
Yes.
All right. Awesome. So happy to hear that. Can I just get your name just so that I know who to write the gift certificate out to?
Maricelis.
All right. Maricelis. All right.
Maricelis Miles.
All right. Thank you so much, Maricelis, and you enjoy that gift certificate from Walk and Roll. If you can, please send me a message on WhatsApp or Facebook so that I can get your details privately off air and have that all ready for you, okay?
Thank you.
All right. Have
a nice day.
Thank you. You too. Have a fantastic day. All right, guys. See, just like that, less than a minute, and you could be a winner of gift certificates for Walk and Roll and get some free food, because who don't like free food? All right, guys, we're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, I'll finish up these conversations that I've been trying to have, like I'm having a little bit of Tourette's on here because I keep getting distracted, but it's okay. We're going to be right back with more Crosstalk after this.
This hour of K-Man Crosstalk is powered by Walk and Roll. Get rid of the cooking chores and give yourself a much-needed break by ordering Walk and Roll. They're sure it'll boost your spirits and make you happy. Visit walkandroll.ky or call 949-0168. More of K-Man Crosstalk brought to you by Walk and Roll is next on Rooster 101.
Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust? My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching. Start finding. Yellow. We know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. Print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces.
Forge Talk is leading Gay Man's Conversation. Be a part of the conversation now. Call 233-1019.
All right, everybody, welcome back. So we still have gift certificates to give away. So if you call in and let us know what you are prepared for, whether it's the reopening, whether it is the weather or back to school, let us know what you're prepared for and you can win a gift certificate from Walk and Roll. We've already had one winner. I want to give away another one. You guys have been awfully quiet, so I want to hook you up. It's been a rough week. You know, we've had all this tropical storm stuff. Back to school is coming up, so I know you guys are frantic. I know there's a lot going on everybody's plate in one way, shape, or form of another. So I want to hook you guys up to make life a little bit easier for you. But on that note of food, we have Darren Zucker, who's the food and beverage manager over at Holiday Inn, as well as Chef Afzal from the Holiday Inn. And they're here to talk to us this morning just about what it was like. And I've titled this one Serving Up Grace, because I was going to say Surviving Grace, but then I was like, no, like I was writing food and beverage, I'm like, no, serving up grace, because there was a lot of grace involved after this storm and the situation that they were in. And I think they have a fantastic story to share about community. And I thought this is something everybody needs to hear, how we work together to overcome our challenges. So good morning, Darren. Good morning, Chef. How are you guys doing today?
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. We're well.
Good. Well, I'm glad to hear that. I kind of felt a little guilty this morning because all of the rain started. And I'm like, oh my gosh, am I traumatizing them as I bring them back in? I'm forcing them to come talk about this, and then and it's raining outside. But thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Yeah. So can you give us just a little bit of background about who you guys are, about the property, so we can just kind of set some context? And for those of you who are streaming, we also have some of the footage that these guys have shared with us, so you can see that. So if you have a chance to go back and look at that, you can go ahead, because again, we weren't expecting all of this. So you guys found yourself in a very interesting position. So I'll let you just share a little bit of who you are, your roles at the hotel, and what exactly happened at the property.
Thank you, Chanda. It's been a wild ride, that's for sure. Mm-hmm. My name's Darren. I've been on island for quite some time, mostly in food and beverage and hotels. I'm the food and beverage director for the Holiday Inn Grand Caymanian. I'm also the associate hotel manager. So we all wear a lot of hats,
right,
especially when something like this unfolds. We also currently, Holiday Inn is assisting government as one of their two isolation facilities. So as this storm came, and we've all been through storms before, most mm-hmm. of us had, you know, we had about 70 isolation guests in the hotel. So unlike, we've just completely gutted and revamped and rebranded mm-hmm. the restaurant, and we're looking forward to the borders opening. That was good news we got yesterday. But currently we're only open on the weekends, so we're running a very lean staff.
Right.
And we're keeping provisions lean as well.
Mm-hmm.
But we have a responsibility that's a little different from most restaurants, and when a storm like this hits, you can just put a shingle up in the window that says, close for grace.
Right, right.
But we had the responsibility for, at the time, about 70 isolation guests
mm-hmm.
Who were with us, many of whom had just arrived on island, maybe had never been to the Caribbean before, certainly hadn't experienced anything like that.
I bet.
So we prepared as best we could. I don't think anybody really expected it to escalate to
exactly
what it actually became. We had the foresight to have some of our key staff members stay on the property, but you know, we didn't have the opportunity to just close for the day.
Mm-hmm.
These folks needed to be fed. If you've been through one storm or one hurricane, it's pretty frightening.
Exactly.
Especially if you're far away from home,
mm-hmm.
the power goes out, communications become challenging. So it was an interesting scenario. We provide 3 meals a day
mm-hmm.
to our isolation guests, and we do that partnering with a couple of other partners.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's dietary needs, there's
right.
vegans, there's gluten-free. So
allergies, all kind of
exactly.
stuff. Exactly. Yeah, yeah.
And when you're in isolation, I should add, it's, you know, TV and the meal is the only thing that you can look forward to
exactly.
for the day.
Yeah.
Some of them are not real happy. Most of them are patient. But mm-hmm. we didn't have an opportunity, or we didn't have the option of not providing for them.
Right.
So Afzal, who's here with me, boy, turned 6 loaves into food for, in this case, 70 folks. He produced, and I'll let him talk a little bit about that, but he produced approaching 200 meals.
Wow.
And part of the challenge was our other partners that are wonderful and reliable couldn't get to the property.
Mm-hmm.
So we
right.
asked some of our associates, some of our team, core team, and it's a very lean team
mm-hmm.
throughout the hotel and restaurant, if they would stay on property. We had space available, and we knew that it might be challenging to get to work the next morning. So,
because again, too, just want to interject here that you had storm surge, and for those of you who are watching online, we're showing that video as well, like courtesy of one of the guests, we're filmed some of this, and we didn't expect to have storm surges coming in. You guys are on the water, so you know there's some clear imagery of that coming through as well. So that, and that came up all the way up to the restaurant as well, right? So that was part of the issue that was happening.
It did. We were behind glass that was, you know, we were inside the restaurant watching the water come up. Some was blowing into the restaurant. We had moved all of the patio furniture and the outdoor furniture. You know, the property's beautifully landscaped and well appointed, but we secured all of that inside. You don't want that blowing.
No, exactly.
Around.
I was just saying that before you guys came in. Yeah.
So we did the best we could, and fortunately, we had the capacity and the willingness from an amazing small team that some were willing to come and stay at the property so that we knew they'd be there when if we needed them. And, you know, they left their properties unattended. They left girlfriends and boyfriends and families, and it was a big sacrifice, but it paid off in this case.
Right. I mean, and that's... and. There's two things going through my mind. One, you kind of, when you're in a hotel, your mindset is already like, everything's going to be taken care of for me. So, and it's not even like a situation where you have regular guests that if push came to shove, they might come out and lend a hand or, you know, whatnot, just to get kind of get you through. You know, again, not the kind of situation where you can like just say, let's light up a grill and throw some burgers on and feed everybody because of all the dietary restrictions and whatnot. So you have a whole bunch of things, a whole bunch of logistics at play here. And then also no electricity.
No electricity.
So I didn't know if you guys had a generator or when that came back, when the electricity came back, or how did that side of things work?
We do have a generator on property. Mm-hmm. It doesn't cover the entire property. Of course, the emergency lighting is all activated. But we had a lot of scared isolation guests, many of whom, you know, returning teachers, people that had been away for medical reasons and had returned, that... you know, all of a sudden it was dark and it was getting hot and the windows were shaking and maybe a little water was blowing in under the doors. Everybody, fortunately, and I'm thankful to God, everybody was safe. We knew they were safe, but communication became a challenge. We had to physically knock on doors.
I didn't even think of that.
Yeah. It's... you know, the power goes out. People want to know what's going on.
Yeah, and you're on an operated phone system, and then the internet is sketchy at best. So,
Yeah, it was. So everybody was wonderful.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, I just am so thankful for the... We had about six people on property that in the hotel, in the restaurant. And this guy to my left, Afzal... You know, we weren't planning on feeding everybody. We were depending upon our partners to provide two-thirds of the meals.
Right.
And they couldn't get there. They tried. They just couldn't.
Yeah. And again, nobody could have expected the amount of trees that were falling and blocking the roads and blocking, you know... That was insane. Just that alone was insane.
Yeah.
So on top of everything the Israelites were dealing with. So Afzal... Thank you so much for your dedication to this. And what was kind of going through your mind as you're like, okay, how do I figure this out? What was some of the...
Yeah, when Darren called me at like 6 o'clock, just I was entering to the kitchen. That kitchen was fully with dark. Then Darren provided me some light and torch for me.
He was cooking by flashlight.
Yeah, just using that. And also the flashlight was sometimes running for around like 2 hours. Then it's... After 2 hours, he's getting the power is going down little by little, you know.
Yeah, it's starting to dim,
Yeah, it's a bit challenging. As Darren told you, it's a bit challenging for us, you know. Just our full aim was to take care of the customer and staff, this one, We understand the situation and also just we want to make everybody happy in the situation because everybody need food.
Yeah, and exactly, shelter, exactly. So I bet you had to get really creative too.
Yeah.
Like, what's in the freezer?
No, the thing is there is no power. The freezer, everything was totally was out,
Oh gosh, then it becomes that kitchen triage of like, what's going to spoil? What can people eat? What can I make fast?
And there is no water also here.
gosh. Oh my gosh. So then, oh, what a nightmare. So, wow. Okay. Well, I'm also curious. I know you're a chef. I know you're used to preparing big meals, but I'm just a little bit curious because I know when I have a small family, I like, I don't cook for more than like six people at a time. So I can't even imagine trying to cook like fix for 70 people and a mass of people all at once. And oh gosh. Okay. And especially when like that, you didn't wake up that morning thinking that that's going to happen. So what were some of the kind of things that you ended up coming up with from what kind of dishes did you end up creating?
Breakfast, we make some patties, three types of patties, chicken, veg, and yeah, because we need to give some option for the customer. Some people who are vegan, we make some patties, yeah, veg, and chicken and beef patties. Mm-hmm. Everything we serve with applesauce. Mm-hmm. For the lunch, we serve with the mahi wraps. Mm-hmm. And some burgers, we say. Then I make some chicken noodles. So some people want some hot,
you know,
they want some hot chicken noodles. So yeah, then, and for the dinner, we make some barbecue chicken with rice and with some local vegetables. Yeah. Uh-huh. But the thing is, the challenging is we have only one oven in the property.
Right.
And also the oven is running with the gas. We have already electric one, but we don't have electric. Yeah. It's a big challenging for us. So at the time, we can't put, for example, the only 2 4-inch pan we can put in the oven.
Right.
So, yeah, every 4-inch pan we make like a 15 dishes. Mm-hmm. So we need to calculate for 200 people.
Oh, my God.
And also, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Well, this was really miraculous, I must say.
It was nothing short of miraculous. And I must say that we have, because we're an isolation facility for government, we have a great deal of security centers, security staff. Mm-hmm. And they do so much more than everybody rose to the occasion. You know, when you're in a crisis situation like this, it does one of two things. It either brings out the best in everybody.
Absolutely.
Or the worst in
absolutely.
Everybody.
Absolutely.
And these folks were running food in 80-degree gusts of wind, soaking wet, making sure that everybody got fed and everybody was checked on and everybody was just made as comfortable as they could be.
Wow. Okay, well, amazing. And thank you for that. We're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, there's another twist to this story that we want to tell you guys about. So stay tuned for that when we come back with more Crosstalk.
This hour of Cayman Crosstalk is powered by Wok and Roll, the ideal place to relish Thai, Malaysian, Indonesian, and Filipino cuisines. For dine-in, take-out, or delivery, visit wokandroll.ky or call 949-0168. More of Cayman Crosstalk, brought to you by Wok and Roll, is next on Rooster 101.
Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust? My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow. We know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. Print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces. Forge collectibles.
This is Tim Hartman for Compass Media. Here are your top news headlines for Thursday, the 26th of August. Forecasters say a tropical wave sweeping through the Caribbean south of Cayman could develop into a tropical depression or storm, most likely by tomorrow. Cayman Islands National Weather Service warned the system is expected to produce significant rainfall across the Cayman Islands, 1 to 2 inches expected, with flooding most likely to occur on Friday. In a severe weather bulletin issued by the National Weather Service yesterday, forecasters said whether or not the system develops into a tropical depression or stronger, Cayman could expect cloudy and overcast skies, scattered thunderstorms with showers likely to be heavy at times over the next 48 hours. And the Cayman Islands government has revised the date for when it hopes the islands will reach the 80% vaccination rate from the 9th of September to the 14th of October. With the original target date just 2 weeks away, the fully vaccinated rate in Cayman is currently at 69%, a rate that has not increased since the 13th of August. The government's original reopening plan, announced by Premier Wayne Panton in early July, involved a limited return of tourism by the 9th of September when Phase 3 of the plan gets underway, contingent on reaching the 80% goal. Panton, speaking at a press briefing yesterday, said Phase 3 will go ahead as planned, even without reaching the 80% target. He pointed out that when quarantine restrictions for vaccinated tourists are lifted on the 14th of October, Phase 4 of the plan, the risk of community transmission in Cayman will rise exponentially. So to be clear, that next phase will go ahead whether or not we have reached those vaccination numbers. HSA.ky has the latest vaccination schedule. Make sure you're following Hazard Management, the Cayman Islands National Weather Service, also gov.ky for all the updated weather information over the next 24 hours. And for these and other of the nation's news headlines, visit caymancompass.com.
Cayman Crosstalk is leading Cayman's conversation. Be a part of the conversation now. Call 233-1019.
All right, everybody, welcome back. We have the team from Holiday Inn here speaking to us about how they had to serve up some grace over the last week after Tropical Storm Grace and take care of their guests. But I just want to give you a quick weather update before we carry on any further. We're going to have partly cloudy skies with a, wow, okay, that's a big loud truck. So partly cloudy skies with 30% chance of showers, becoming cloudy by night with scattered showers and some thunder. Winds are east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots. At daytime, becoming 20 to 25 knots by night. So we're going to see a little bit of a increase in the winds tonight, as well as the rain, because remember, we have that rain and advisory starting today, carrying on into tomorrow. So not that we want any of that. I mean, it's good and bad. I mean, I'm two minds about it, because we also have I see the temperatures cooling down a bit as well. So this is the first time I've seen a slight change in the actual temperature. So we're going to have a high of 86, where previously it was looking more like 89, 88, 89. So I don't know if you guys felt it too, but there was a little bit of drop in the temperature, and the low is 76. So I'm fingers crossed that maybe we're cooling down a little bit, so it's not always a bad thing, but we're still not out of the threat, and not that we need a ton of rain or a ton of anything right now after we're just in recovery mode. Seas are going to be rough with wave heights of 4 to 6 feet, and small crafts should exercise caution over open water. So there you guys have it. Please be safe. If you know, if you have to go out in the water, please be really, really safe, and or just don't go. So anyway, guys, that's what it's looking like, and we have our guests here, and I just think that this is such an amazing story about people coming together, and how when we really have to make a difference, we can make a difference. And I promised you all there was a bit of a twist to this Holiday Inn story. Not only did they have the isolation guests, 70 of them approximately, at the hotel, but then remember when we had that plane from Canada that had to have an emergency landing here, and then they also became quarantine guests. So Darren, what happened in that situation?
They were actually, the plane came down from Toronto, I think. Mm-hmm. And we got a call from government that we work closely with as, mm-hmm. as one of their partners in the whole isolation scheme of things, that the plane had some technical difficulties, mm-hmm. and was not able to take off. So we got a call, and they said, you know, we're sending quite a few people your way. They're going to need to be fed. There's dogs on board. I think we had 4 or 5 dogs. So not only did we have to scrape together meals and plan to feed them, and again, Mike Dill, who's one that works with us as a partner in feeding these folks, he over at 7 Mile Greens and 7 Mile Burgers literally pulled another miraculous 6 loaves to feed mm-hmm. everyone, and delivered the next day enough meals. We had to arrange for dog food to be delivered. Mm-hmm. So these guests appeared on our doorstep without much notice.
Right.
they had spent 5 hours
on
the plane.
Because you didn't have enough dealing with.
Yeah, really. Well, it was okay. You know what? There's a certain level of excitement under stress.
It kind of gives you that next adrenaline rush, right? That's like, oh, I'm tired, but now I'm not tired anymore because I got to go do this other thing.
Yeah, you know what? We've got some great leadership at the hotel that was on property, so they keep... Our boss, Greg Ray, keeps everybody calm.
It's, nice.
You know, he keeps everybody kind of laughing and smiling. Uh-huh. So we dealt with it. The people understood. They had spent 5 hours on the tarmac, I think, before they came to us. Mm-hmm. I really felt sorry for the dogs. These dogs were on their way back to Canada or to Canada. Mm-hmm. And they, you know, travel is stressful for those of us that travel frequently.
Exactly.
These poor dogs were...
Yeah.
Some were well-behaved, some were freaked out.
Yeah.
They needed to be walked. You know,
you can't tell them what's going on.
Yeah, exactly. So we got everybody comfortable.
Yeah.
We, with Mike Dill's help, we got everybody fed. Humane Society or some others dropped off some provisions for the dogs. Now, these dogs have to be walked.
Oh, my gosh. I didn't even think of this.
Yeah. And so because these are isolation patients, although they'd only – or guests, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Although they'd only been on the plane for a few hours, you can't just say, go wander around the property.
Yeah, release them into the
same,
public.
The same rules apply.
Okay.
So whenever the dogs – needed to be walked, which was sometimes every couple hours. We kept all the pets on the first floor. We had to move throughout both of these events. You want to move people up off the ground floor
because
we don't know what to expect. But we kept the pets. By now, the worst of grace was over.
Right, right.
So, you know, we had to alert, again, the security staff, say, hey, you know, room such and such needs a dog walk. So they would have to escort.
Yeah.
You know, we've all had an issue with mosquitoes recently.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw the mosquito plane up the other day and the truck out. So thank you, mosquito
Especially
research and control.
Water settling and everything.
But after the all that standing water, it doesn't take them long to spring back.
Mm-hmm.
So I just, it was fun. It was a wild ride. It was an adventure. I don't want to do it again this week, but you know what? We're better prepared this week if
me
we need
either.
It to.
Me either.
Those of us that have been through tropical storms or hurricanes or whatever you want to call grace, it's still frightening.
Absolutely. Again, and just another testament of how quickly things can go badly, like weather-wise, like, you know. And how's the property doing now? You had some trees fall. You had like a big, really big palm tree.
We had we had a couple of like 35-foot Bismarcks come down. We immediately started the cleanup. We lost a good portion of our dock. It was all over the property. Our cabanas, I don't know if those of you that are familiar with the property might know, we had one of the big fiberglass iguanas that as the storm came in around 7:30 in the morning, I was watching it come closer to the freshwater pool, and it survived the storm well, but we immediately started cleanup, and it continues. We had to get all the debris that was floating around in the water.
Yeah, I mean, and that's a huge property. I mean, I know I'm still kind of mopping and remopping and remopping up until the last few days, so that's a lot of cleanup work and rebuilding and stuff, even if the damage wasn't surmountable. Like, the whole place wasn't destroyed, but just it's enough to keep you busy for a while. I think people don't understand what some of these efforts can look like in reality, especially if they haven't had any kind of damage. So, you know, everybody got like messy yards from all of the debris. But then when you're talking about trees and then having, because I watched on our property and a few other properties near us that, you know, all of the, you know, trees having to be sawed up, and then you have to take that somewhere. And then it sits there until someone can come collect it, or you can take it off wherever it needs to go. So it's days and days. And I don't think people quite can fathom, if they haven't had to deal with it, that it's days and days, almost like maybe sometimes weeks of cleanup, depending on the size of the property and the damage that was inflicted. So,
well, those that are familiar with our property, it's a large property. Mm-hmm. It's really beautifully landscaped.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And we lost some landscaping. Some of the light poles came down.
Mm.
You know, we're located behind the golf course there, the North Sound Club, and there were tree limbs down. But And those people that you need to assist with the cleanup, they're really busy.
Everybody's cleaning up. And, you know, your staff have lives too, so they can't just be there. Like, you know, they're balancing their personal disasters as well as their employment disasters. So I think it can stretch everybody thin in that regard, and people don't quite, you know, people need to just be mindful of that, because we're not quite out of that situation. It's only been a week and people are still kind of even if they're back in order and functional, they're exhausted.
It was exhausting, but the staff that couldn't get there to assist for various reasons, you know, as soon as they could, the next morning, everybody on our small team showed up. We've got an amazing maintenance department.
Fantastic.
And everything was up and running pretty efficiently.
Good.
By the next day, the two big Bismarck palms that you're referring to, I know I sent you some photos of them. They're huge. I mean, you don't want to lose those.
No, exactly.
So we had made plans and we're going to stand them back up with some heavy equipment to get the heavy equipment in, and we had to remove ground lighting. There's a lot of moving
parts. Of course, yeah.
And we were going to do that yesterday, and then we heard about this front coming through, and we thought, you know, we only want to do this once.
Exactly.
We don't want to do it again 2 days from now. Yeah. So we held off on that, but I believe today they're going to erect it. So the property's coming back into good shape.
Mm-hmm.
We'll have to replace some of the landscaping, and we were already working on rebuilding the dock.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, we got through it. We learned some things.
Yep.
We'll be better prepared.
Nothing like an emergency to teach you some lessons.
But again, I just can't give enough credit to our staff.
Yeah.
Naturally, teach some lesson for.
We mentioned the dogs, and I'm also a cat owner. I've previously a dog owner, but right now I'm a cat owner. And there was a special little cat, Ginger, that.
You know, there's a cat that we love dearly who's bit of an attitude problem, but he lives on the property. He's an adult feral cat. He's been with Holiday Inn longer than I have. He's an outdoor cat.
Mm-hmm.
But he showed up. I was concerned. You know, this little guy, I could show you the scars on my hand. I feed him way too many times a day, and he's old. He's missing a few teeth. His tongue's usually hanging out. He's not a handsome fella, but we love him. And he's coming around. I'll tell you what, when I was so almost tearful when he showed up, I guess about 11 o'clock in the morning, the day of the storm, wet, with a worse attitude than ever, hungry, crying. And for the first, I've been feeding him for about a year now. I just want to pet him.
Mm-hmm.
He, for the first time, I think any human has been able to make contact with him. He's coming around. I think
after all this time, like I said, I have a cat, and I noticed, you know, she was tolerant of a lot of it, but the next couple of days she was acting very differently, very strange. She wanted a lot more attention, a lot more petting and cuddles. So they go through it too, and we do wonder. And in Tropical Storm Etta, the chickens were the concern, because they were coming out, and I saw there was one chicken that just kind of sheltered on our porch somewhere, and we were just watching. We're like, guy, you better go somewhere. You better find somewhere else, because this isn't the right spot for you. So all those animals out there have to figure out themselves. And I just want to say on that note a big thank you to everyone who helped foster some of the pets and at the Humane Society, because I know they're extremely grateful. I think some people have kind of kept them a little bit longer as well. So you might have adopted a new fur baby during this time. So big thank you to everybody who assisted with that effort as well. So gentlemen, anything else you want to tell our listeners before you leave?
Thank you for this opportunity.
No problem. Pleasure having you.
You know, we've got a great new restaurant bar that we're looking forward to opening full time right now. We're just open on the weekends, but come out. It's got a whole, if you've ever been to the Blue Iguana, was the prior name, we've completely redone it and made it. I've been here for a while, and there used to be a lot of affordable Caribbean kind of atmosphere, chill spots, and many of them have disappeared over the years, and there's some lovely new replacements, but we missed that, so that's kind of what we're trying to recreate. So we're open on the weekends. Love for people to come out and see us.
Well, I would be remiss if I didn't ask you how you guys are, you know, feeling about the reopening with the press conference yesterday. So 14th of October is the big date that they're looking at, but 9th the, you know, we still have the soft reopening. Hi, good morning, caller. You're live on Crosstalk. How are you?
Yes, good morning. Can I get your WhatsApp number, please?
Oh, sure. Yes, it's 324.
324.
1019. 1019. All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. So, yeah. So we had the big, we're going to still have the, we're going to do the opening next month for vaccinated clients. I mean, and you guys have still had people coming through being a quarantine partner, but we're going to see that uptick start to slowly build mm-hmm. between September 9th and October 14th for the big dates. So are you guys excited? Are you guys nervous? What's your thoughts?
Yes. we're really excited. You know, it's been a very unique year and a half for all of us. And I must say that it's much more fun to be accommodating and serving folks that are on vacation and having the best 2 weeks of their life than mm-hmm. it is people that are stressed and have come from overseas and are feel like they're trapped.
Right.
All for the right reasons. So we're looking forward to that. Mm-hmm. We've kept things very lean. Mm-hmm. And been able to because we are primarily the isolation facility. But we need to staff up as every restaurant and hotel will be, and we're hopeful. We've certainly, we welcome talented, motivated local folks. That would be the quickest solution to every restaurant's needs. So come out. Mm-hmm. Come out and, you know.
And I think you guys are in a very unique position because you've seen, being a quarantine partner, that you've seen how everything ticks and how everything works, and a lot like not all, every hotel will have had that experience as well. So, you know, if there are any, like, let's be real, there's going to be risks, right? So not every facility is going to be able to be have the foresight, the experience to deal with any challenges that have come up. So. Yeah. I think you guys are in a very...
You know, if I can say, just the government has entrusted us with looking after the isolation guests, and that's a huge responsibility, mm-hmm. and I really just want to thank them, and I appreciate their faith in us. I don't think we've let them down, and I just really appreciate, we all appreciate that opportunity, because while other places were closed, we were staying busy with a very small, concentrated, lean staff. Now we need to grow that team to adapt back to life, normal life.
Right. Okay, well, gentlemen, thank you very much. And also, I just want to say thank you to Darren. He brought me a Twix bar, and I was like, now this is a good food and beverage manager, right? He brings the snacks, and
breakfast.
he knew that Twix was my favorite. I'm like, how'd you know? So, all right, gentlemen, thank you so much. And I know you, you're going to go on gold and have a chat with my buddy Doug, Dr. Doug, over there in a few minutes. So, again, just thank you for all of your efforts. Thank you for coming on. Thank you for sharing what you are doing in our community.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much.
All right, guys, so stay tuned. We're going to have PC Powery coming on next to talk about road safety and as we prepare for back to school, as well as personal safety with some of the recent assaults we've been having. So I want to talk to her about that. How do we protect ourselves? What do we need to be prepared for? All when we return with more Crosstalk after this.
This hour of Cayman Crosstalk is powered by Walk and Roll. Get rid of the cooking chores and give yourself a much-needed break by ordering Walk and Roll. They're sure it'll boost your spirits and make you happy. Visit walkandroll.ky or call 949-0168. More of Cayman Crosstalk brought to you by Walk and Roll is next on Rooster 101.
Now here at Popeye's, we don't usually...
Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust. My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow. We know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces. Forge collectibles, not lifeless paper. Create memories, not nuisances. Raise the standard of...
Crosstalk is leading Gay Man's Conversation. Be a part of the conversation now. Call 233-1019.
Hello, hello. Welcome back, guys. It's 7:53 in the studio, and we are having a great conversation this morning. We're about to have PC Powery come on to talk about safety, personal safety from assaults, and road safety as well. So excited to talk to her in just a few minutes, but just wanted to remind you guys that we do have some severe weather alerts that we need to watch out for. We're expecting a lot of rain over the next couple days, and small craft advisories are in effect and whatnot. So make sure that you are prepared, that, you know, again, even though this isn't necessarily extreme weather in terms of hurricanes and whatnot, we just came through something. The ground is a little bit saturated still. We've had a little time to dry out, but if we have back-to-back-to-back systems, then we're also going to be running risks of flooding, higher risks of flooding. So we're already at risk of flooding, but higher risks. So just want to remind you guys of that. So with the back to school stuff, I also, like, there's so many things going on. I also saw that there was some edibles that Customs and Border Control had confiscated. So those, if you don't know what edibles are, edibles are the drugs, and they're packaged in edible form. So they're just commonly referred to as edibles. So it's marijuana that is infused into food, right? And one of the things is that they typically are candies and things that would be attractive to young people. So you just have to be very, very, very cautious, and just, I want parents just to be on the lookout for the fact that these things are out there, and school-age children could be exposed to it. So we just have to make sure that we're keeping that straight. The other thing, just before we get into the conversation with PC Powery, that this crate challenge that has been going around on the internet, like, please, Cayman, if you can just ignore anything on social media, please ignore that one. It is silly. I actually see there's no purpose to this thing. You are not a gymnast. You are not an acrobat. If you are not a professional, then please, you know, if you see your child asking you, mommy, can I get some crates? Can I need like 25 crates? I don't know how many it is. It's like some ridiculous number of crates. But if you start to see your kid asking you and collecting milk crates and setting up something outside, or even your friends, then I want you to please just shut that down. I've seen some ridiculous things. I've seen people, okay, first of all, let me tell you what a crate challenge is, because some people are like, what is this crate challenge? So they basically make, it's not even a pyramid. It's like they take single crates, line them up, stack, 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 and it goes up. And I think some of them I've seen have like 13 crates in the middle. So you start off with one, then two, then three, then four, and then they stack them up, and you have to walk across it. So of course it's a balancing act, right? And by the time you get to the middle, your center of gravity is higher, you're starting to get shaky. And I have seen people take such tremendous falls. These are just stacked crates. They are not even tied together. There's no. So when you fall, it's like Legos, and everything just comes tumbling down. And I have seen people take the most extraordinary licks, and I'm like, that's a broken rib. He's gonna have back problems for the rest of his life. Broken arm. Like, it is ridiculous. People have gone in them with bicycles, high heels, all kind of things. And you know, for like maybe half a second, I can see the appeal of the danger and the, oh, let's try this out. And it's almost become this like backyard game. But then I've seen some of it start to turn really ugly and malicious. I saw this mature gentleman, I won't say older, like old, but he was mature. Like, obviously a mature guy, 40 plus. And he was at the top and getting ready to come down. So he's smack in the middle at the top, and somebody kicked the crates down while he was on top of it. And I was like, why would you do that? And I said, you know, it was in that moment that I was like, if I see anybody doing this crate challenge, I'm calling 911. Like, I'm calling the police. I'm calling 911, because it has just gotten, it went from some little backyard fun thing to now serious injury, and people starting to get overly competitive to the point of it being malicious. And I'm like, that's an assault charge right there, that you actually went out to physically hurt this person by making them fall down. So anyway, and take a quick break. BC Power is here. We're just going to take a quick break, get some news, and when we come back, we'll talk all about our personal and road safety when we return with more Crosstalk.
We note that any views expressed on Cayman Crosstalk do not necessarily reflect or represent the views of Compass Media, its staff, or contributors. Individuals who choose to call or comment do so at their own risk and should ensure that they comply with all laws and regulations, including those relating to defamation and privacy. Have your say on 233-1019, WhatsApp message 324-1019, or find us on Facebook at Cayman Crosstalk. This is Cayman Crosstalk on Rooster 101, leading Cayman Man's conversation.
Good morning. This is Tim Hartman for Compass Media. Here are your top news headlines for Thursday, the 26th of August. Forecasters say a tropical wave sweeping through the Caribbean south of Cayman could develop into a tropical depression or storm, most likely by tomorrow. Cayman Islands National Weather Service warned the system is expected to produce significant rainfall across the Cayman Islands, 1 to 2 inches expected, with flooding most likely to occur on Friday. In a severe weather bulletin issued by the National Weather Service yesterday, forecasters said whether or not the system develops into a tropical depression or stronger, Cayman could expect cloudy and overcast skies, scattered thunderstorms with showers likely to be heavy at times over the next 48 hours. And the Cayman Islands government has revised the date for when it hopes the islands will reach the 80% vaccination rate from the 9th of September to the 14th of October. With the original target date just 2 weeks away, the fully vaccinated rate in Cayman is currently at 69%, a rate that has not increased since the 13th of August. The government's original reopening plan, announced by Premier Wayne Panton in early July, involved a limited return of tourism by the 9th of September when Phase 3 of the plan gets underway, contingent on reaching the 80% goal. Panton, speaking at a press briefing yesterday, said Phase 3 will go ahead as planned even without reaching the 80% target. He pointed out that when quarantine restrictions for vaccinated tourists are lifted on the 14th of October, Phase 4 of the plan, the risk of community transmission in Cayman will rise exponentially. So to be clear, that next phase will go ahead whether or not we have reached those vaccination numbers. HSA.ky has the latest vaccination schedule. Make sure you're following hazard management, the Cayman Islands National Weather Service, also gov.ky for all the updated weather information over the next 24 hours. And for these and other of the nation's news headlines, visit caymancompass.com.
Now back to Cayman Crosstalk. Join the conversation. Call the Crosstalk hotline, 233-1019. Brought to you by Global Medical Center and Laboratory.
All right, welcome back. It's 8 o'clock on the dot, and we have PC Power in here. We always love to have PC Power when she comes through and gives us some good information, as well as our RCIPS update. So, morning. How are you today?
Good morning. Thank you. I'm doing great. I feel like it's been a while since I've been on for some reason. I don't know.
It does feel that way. It's like the time is moving fast and slow.
Yeah.
Because it has been a month. We schedule, you know, we have our conversation scheduled for the end of the month updates.
I think the reason why is that for the past few months, we've had reason to come in like in between.
That's
true. But this month we haven't. So
that is so true.
Which is probably a good thing. It means that maybe people are behaving and that kind of stuff, you know, but
we can hope. But but on that note, there are some issues that we do need to talk about. Primarily, we wanted to discuss road safety because it's back to school season. So.
Yes. But before we do that, I also want to discuss some personal safety specifically for women.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Because I know that you probably have seen that we've been pushing out some PRs, press releases, where women appear to have been targeted sexually.
Mm-hmm.
And so with that being said, I would just want to make sure that people are aware of it, to just bring some light to the press releases for you to go back and have a look at them. And also just a few tips. And no, we're not victim blaming, but we also want to make sure that we do the best that we can to make sure that we are the safest that we possibly can be.
Yes, and I kind of said the same thing when I was bringing the attention to some of these assaults that were in these press releases, because there was one attempted abduction that
right.
was early evening, like yeah. 8 o'clock.
Right.
Still, you know, people are still out and about driving. Yes. You might just be going to walk your dog, that kind of
yeah.
time. So it's
mm-hmm.
not extremely
right.
late, and it's, you know, in a populated area.
Yes.
And
very bizarre.
Yeah.
So
I was wondering that yeah. because they were in a van, so it did look like
yeah.
they were out, in my opinion, reading it, out looking for some trouble.
Right. Either out looking for some trouble or saw an opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, the area might appear to be isolated, mm-hmm. Populated, mm-hmm. but in the grand scheme of things, people are really just going about their business and minding their own business.
True.
I guess these persons know that as mm-hmm. well. So, you know, they made an attempt. They weren't successful, thankfully. But at the same time, you know, like if you're going walking, and it doesn't even appear, these things doesn't even appear to, fall into the category of that incident, because at that time of evening, the places aren't really that dark, but mm-hmm. make sure that you're walking in well-lit areas. If you can
sure.
avoid it, don't walk alone.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure that you don't have your earphones in both ears so that you're aware of your surroundings.
Mm-hmm.
Have your phone in your hand, ready to go. Unfortunately, these are the times that we live in.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And again, like I know you mentioned, we're not trying to victim shame anybody, but we do need to be vigilant. We do need
yes.
to be cautious, because we don't, at the end of the day, prevention is better than cure.
Right.
We don't want to find ourselves in these situations,
right.
especially
we,
knowing that this
yeah,
is
Yeah, we have to make sure that our behavior is defensive.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, and it is unfortunate, because you know, I know that for a lot of us, it's not what we're used to in Cayman,
mm-hmm.
But we have to make sure that we adapt to the changes that are happening, whether those changes are good or bad.
Yeah, and I mean, you've been advising us on a lot of the sexual harassment conversations that we've been having from 2 months ago,
right?
And the escalation of what that looks
right.
like.
And this is a prime example of that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah. But also, we've also put out a rape press release
mm-hmm.
recently as well, where a lady was out drinking
yeah.
and ended up in a situation where she was raped. And
mm-hmm.
so we have to make sure that when we do go out, again, go out in groups, go out with your friends.
Exactly.
Don't go out on your own, please. And make sure that you guys are looking out for each other.
Right.
Make sure that you're not drinking to the point where you're too inebriated, especially if you decided to go out alone.
Mm-hmm.
And don't take rides from strangers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, make sure that you plan how you're getting home when you're planning the
right.
rest of your way. And stick to the plan. That's important. Stick to the plan.
Right. That's
yes.
very important.
Yes. Don't leave your drinks laying around either.
Yeah.
Make sure that if you've
right.
left your drink somewhere, you get a fresh one. Don't, mm-hmm. you know, go back to that one.
So tell me, like, are we seeing, what's the frequency in like the roofing and the drink spiking? I haven't heard about it recently.
No,
so I'm just curious.
So we haven't. I mean, these are just general tips.
Yeah.
We haven't heard any reports of it. But one of the things that we do know is that sexual crimes and domestic crimes are grossly underreported.
Exactly. Yeah.
So just because we don't see the reports coming in, it doesn't mean that they're not happening.
True.
And not doesn't mean that we shouldn't
yeah.
be prepared for it.
Yeah. And again, like if you have been out drinking and you're very inebriated, and it's kind of sometimes hard to tell, did I just drink too much or was I drugged?
Yeah, but
or,
you know, if you feel a certain type of way, stop drinking right away and start
right.
drinking water.
Yeah.
Start hydrating.
Yeah.
And keep your phone close.
Yeah.
Again, please keep your phone close and make sure that it's in a condition where it's fully charged. It has credit if that's what it needs,
mm-hmm.
So that you can call somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what? I also want to encourage you that if you go out with your group of friends and you guys go home separately, make sure that you call one another when you get home too, and make
yeah.
sure that everybody got home safely and, you know, if not, then
yeah. It just takes a couple minutes to just check stay up. Home.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah,
it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Just you know, generally, just look out for each other and make sure that we keep each other safe.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, absolutely necessary. And I just wanted to so. We have this just on that note before I move on to the next thing that there's self-defense courses available throughout the island. There's all like they're out there. So if that's something that you feel you just want to take a little refresher course on that, get yourself ready and prepared. Because even so, like I saw something where they were saying that a woman that's walking on the road with a lot of confidence,
mm-hmm.
a predator is not, it's going to be less likely. It's mm-hmm. not to say that won't happen, but, mm-hmm. You know, than somebody who's mm-hmm. kind of looking scared and more yeah. like a, like prey.
And these are precautions.
Right.
You know, they're not, it's not a guarantee that nothing is going to happen to mm-hmm. you, but you'll reduce your chances mm-hmm. If you take these precautions.
Right. And yeah. if you can't make it to a physical class, there's tons of YouTube safety videos that at least have a look, at least prepare a little bit. The good thing about classes are that at least you get that experience. So if it does, you know, unfortunately, if it did happen mm-hmm. to you, you are not completely surprised. You know exactly mm-hmm. where to put your body, but it's, yeah. But still the other classes are... the online tips and stuff is at least helpful that you have some idea. Yeah. It might click in your, the back of your brain somewhere.
Yeah.
And I know this isn't quite related to these sexual assault situations, but there was another more recent public disorder situation.
Yes.
And I'm kind of saying this in terms of you might find yourself in a situation where things are just kind of, whether it's at a bar or at a party and things just kind of get crazy, your personal safety is also important in mm-hmm. those situations. So if we find ourselves kind of in a public situation that's going wrong,
mm-hmm.
what's some of the best options for us?
I mean, to me, if you find yourself in a public situation, especially anything like at a liquor license premise or anywhere where there's a large crowd, I say to remove yourself from the situation as best as possible. And if mm-hmm. that is impossible, call for help, scream, yeah. whatever you need to do to get the attention of someone to help you out.
Yeah. Be obnoxious.
Yes. Yeah. You know, don't discount a good scream.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah. Yeah.
Even if you're in an isolated place, still make as much noise as you possibly can because you never know who might be nearby and could come to your aid.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Yeah. And I will say, make the phone call because I think everybody always
yes.
thinks somebody else is going to call 911.
No,
you call.
You call.
So,
yeah. Better to have too many calls than none at all.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. All right. So the other thing you wanted to address with us was the back to school safety.
Yes.
Road safety particularly.
Our kiddos are going back to school.
Yeah.
And so the roads are going to be very, very different come Monday morning. Mm-hmm. It's already started because the private
it, yeah.
schools are in.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to make sure that we tailor our times to these changes that are going to happen.
Right.
Don't be caught surprised on Monday morning when there's a line of traffic that you didn't expect.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure that you leave home in enough time to get to work on time.
Mm-hmm.
And drive with courtesy. You
yeah.
know, drive defensively as well. Make sure that you're the one that are looking out for the people mm-hmm. who are, you know, doing the wrong thing so that you're not caught unawares. Specifically, I want to say look out for school zones.
Mm-hmm.
Remember that each school zone is 50 miles per hour and that the fines are doubled in
mm-hmm.
those areas.
Mm-hmm.
So it's $40 per mile over the limit that you go over that 50 miles if you are prosecuted.
Per mile.
Per mile.
That,
right.
So
right.
So if the speed limit is 25 and it's 15 in the school,
yeah.
but you don't start, you like, you know, and I saw it, I've seen it so much this week where people
yeah.
are just, I mean, every day people are out there driving crazy,
yes.
but I was like two particular incidents where I was coming off of Bobby Thompson there, the roundabout, and somebody came right off the roundabout and overtook me. And I was already, and that's like a 30. And I think I was just like at the top of like right at the 30 and they zoomed across me and I'm like, you have to at least be going 50 miles an hour.
Yeah.
I see you like how fast they reached the light. And I was like, That was like extremely unnecessary at 6 o'clock in the morning.
I just want to say as well, you know, when the speed zone is 15 miles per hour, it's very easy to double that speed. So please be very careful of that as well.
That's a good point.
You don't want to be doubling that speed, especially in the school zone. You might think that 30 miles per hour isn't anything, but then in comparison to if you're going at that speed and hit a child, it's a fatal
exactly.
injury.
Exactly.
So please make sure that you're not doubling the speed limit.
Yeah.
And more than double the speed limit means that you will be going to court and you will be disqualified if you're prosecuted for that.
Yeah.
So, and again, that's very easy to do.
Well,
so,
thank you for reminding us of that. Because, yeah, going about 30 miles an hour feels natural in a car.
Yes.
Right?
So please be very, very aware. And, of course, our officers are going to be in these school zones in the mornings making sure that people are doing what they're supposed to be doing in an effort to keeping our children safe. School buses will be out as well.
Yeah, right.
Please make sure that you remember that you have to stop on both sides of the roads when the school bus stops.
Mm-hmm.
So the oncoming traffic as well as the traffic behind. This is important because you don't know which direction the children going on or off are coming from.
Mm-hmm.
Again, this is an offense as well. So if you violate this, sometimes the wardens and the bus drivers record license plates and stuff if they're not able to call the police at that time. So please be on the lookout for these things.
Absolutely.
Yes.
All right, PC Power, is there anything else you want to...
Just a bit of a weekend message as well, because it's going to be Friday tomorrow.
Yep.
I just want to remind everybody, please do not drink and drive.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be a heavy shopping weekend as well with the back to school stuff. So business owners, make sure that your cameras are properly placed. Make sure that you make your deposits on time. Don't leave any cash in your business overnight if you can avoid it. Do as many drop-offs as possible. If you need extra security for the weekend because you know it's going to be busy, make sure that you sort that out tomorrow. And also, for shoppers, make sure that you're not leaving your stuff in the cars when you're parking them for long times.
Right.
For people to see. Put them in the trunk. When you're moving from place to place, you buy something here, you buy something there.
A lot of these are just crimes of opportunities.
Right, so that people can see. And don't leave any valuables in your car overnight or for extended periods.
Mm-hmm.
Don't leave cash in your car, especially in a visible area.
Mm-hmm.
Just generally be safe. Don't speed. The roads are going to be wet this weekend.
It's already looking cloudy out there.
Right. So remember to reduce your speed at least 10 to 20 miles under the speed limit so that you can avoid being in a collision with the slick roads.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Save the racing for the racetracks.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much for coming in. And we're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back with more Crosstalk after this.
Crosstalk will be back to leading gay man's conversation shortly on Rooster 101.
Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust? My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow, we know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. Print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces. Forge collectibles, not lifeless paper. Create memories, not nuisances. Raise the standard of old print designs and eliminate the hassle of overseas services. Contact us today. Email us at printshop@compassmedia.ky or call 949-5111 for more details.
Cayman Crosstalk. Join the conversation. Call the Crosstalk Hotline, 233-1019. Brought to you by Global Medical Center and Laboratory.
All right, everybody, welcome back. It is 8:17, and your time check is brought to you by CIBC First Caribbean Bank. So hopefully you guys have left home already and remembered your umbrella, because as we have been talking over the last few minutes, it's just gotten darker and darker and darker outside. And there's one big old gray cloud hanging out over central Georgetown. So not looking too good right now. PC Powery just has stayed for a couple more minutes. So we always try to find some reason to keep her here. Like, okay, you're done? No. So we've tricked her into staying longer. I just want to remind you guys, too, that we do have a cold case coming out on the Compass Cold Case series. It is Karen Baker. So, again, we were just talking about abduction and safety. And Ms. Baker, this was the evening of the 30th of July, 2011. Ms. Carrie Ann Baker disappeared without a trace. So we were just talking about the importance of making sure you let people get home safely. And sometimes when you're grown, it's a weird situation, right? Yeah. Like, you don't want people knowing your business.
Yeah.
And you live your life, and especially young people. And I have this conversation with my son all the time that, like, you're an adult. I'm not going to tell you can't do something. Mm-hmm. And I've had to explain this, and this is just a little parenting tip for those who might need it, is I know teenagers can kind of feel like we want our own freedom. And it's like just having that conversation with them and practicing it as well. So being that model, like, I'll tell him, hey, I'm going to the grocery store. I'm going to go out for a walk. And it's for my own safety as well. But also it's just that communication and practicing that I'm letting you know, I'm modeling that for you.
Yeah.
And I'm like, you know, sometimes they don't want to tell us they're going to a party or they're going to go meet a girl or a boy. And I'm just kind of like, well, you're an adult.
Yeah.
I just need to know you're safe.
Yeah. But, you know, and you can initiate the conversation in a sneaky way as well. You know, like, so what are you doing this weekend? You know,
exactly.
Anything fun? And it's just looking out for one another.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And he started to see that and appreciate that. I'm like, look, I'm not bothered. If you want to go hang out with your friends, if you're going to the club, you're an adult. I just need to know that if something were to happen to you, if you didn't come home, who do I call? Which friend do I start with? Who do I, where do I start looking if I had to call the police? That I said, well, he said he was going out to the club, or he said he was going by his friend's house, and he left the friend's house, and at least I know where to start the search party. So, and I think once we can let young people know it's not about control, it's more just about we just want to make sure you're okay, then it starts to ease them back a little bit. And again, it goes for our adults. I practiced for years, especially after the situation with Estella, like, I always make sure that my girlfriends get in their car and I see them at least start to drive off, that they're...
And we all leave at the same time.
Exactly. Yeah. And then we let each other know we get home, because, you might stop and get some pizza from the gas station. I don't know what you're going to do in between getting home, and you might not text me for another hour, but at least I know at some point that was the last time I saw you and you told me you got home at some point.
Yeah.
So, on that note again, so we have the cold case with Carrie Ann Baker coming up on the Compass. So we'll have that report, and then we'll probably have that for you guys next week and play that and go through that here on Crosstalk. But public is always being asked for information about any of these cold cases and missing persons. And I know, PC Power, you wanted to just give us information again on tip lines and confidential information.
Of course, we have our website. You can visit our website, and we have a submit a tip function on there. That submit a tip function, you can use it anonymously if you choose, and it's media friendly, so you can upload images or videos when you're submitting as well. So if you caught something on your dash cam that you thought that we need to know, like, for instance, you know, somebody not stopping for the school bus, please do let us know. At the very least, we can speak to that person and let them know, because it's quite possible, you know, people forget. It's, I don't know.
No problem. I was just kind of thinking too, like, are you getting more people, just with the increase of technology and driving, are you getting more dash cam footage coming
in. We do,
in
actually, we do. And we definitely do appreciate it because it lets us know, at the very least, it lets us know where we need to tailor our enforcement mm-hmm. and education. And so we do appreciate the tips coming in, and we want to encourage them to continue to come in as well.
I would also think it makes evidence a lot easier when situations happen.
Well, that's a little trickier.
Oh, okay.
In order for us to prosecute based on something that somebody submitted, mm-hmm. that person would have to also provide us with a statement to say that this was their footage from their device and it wasn't secondhand information and that kind of thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So, but we are also willing, especially for dangerous driving type of things. Those are very serious road offenses. And so if you didn't want to submit your tip confidentially, you can also leave your information mm-hmm. with us, and we can get back to you. We can reach out to you if we needed more information mm-hmm. or to find out if you are willing to provide that evidence to us and, you know, help us out with a prosecution.
Yeah, well, that's good to know, because I mm-hmm. know some people, you know, just thinking like the public that, and I, even though I'm a lawyer, I didn't do criminal law. Like, I did the class.
Yeah, yeah,
I didn't
class.
Practice this. So, you know, I'm still sometimes learning the protocols and the procedures along with you guys, and that's why I like to have these conversations with you. That, you know, because the general public's like, well, I saw it on social media, so why can't the police just use that
to
prosecute?
So that's the reason. But even though we can't prosecute just based on that, mm-hmm. A lot of times it warrants us just going and speaking to that person and warning them not to continue that type of behavior and make them know that we are aware of the fact that their vehicle was used to commit an offense, which means that it's quite possible we'd be looking out for you committing that offense again.
Right.
And, you know, don't knock it, because it quite possibly is a very good deterrent.
Yeah, I'm laughing because customized license plates, it has been like, the funny thing is, it's one thing remembering a license plate number, right?
Yes.
But all of the incidents that have happened to me this week where I've seen people just being totally obnoxious on the road, like extremely reckless, obnoxious, I'm just like, you have a customized license plate, dude.
For goodness
sake. It's like, really not that
I'm not going to forget it. I'm not.
So it's just like, but I just thought that was kind of funny and coincidental.
Yeah.
Last thing, I know there's a campaign going on that we've had for the roundabouts, and the kids want kids of Cayman want everyone to drive safely. So if you haven't seen that, that's been going out. Any words of advice on the roundabout usage?
My first advice is to visit the NRA website. Mm-hmm. The NRA website has directions on how to use the roundabouts, especially the newer, bigger ones.
Yes, because when it starts with three lanes, I'm like, where do I come on and off?
Yes.
How does this work?
And the second advice that I have is just to, I mean, the directions are there on the roadway. Mm-hmm. Use the arrows. Mm-hmm. You know, they're there for a reason. So they'll curve and point and show you what lane you need to be in order to get to where. And indicate on the roundabouts. That's very important, because the roundabouts are supposed to be fluid.
Yeah.
However, because people don't use their indicators to let people know where they're going, mm-hmm. the other parties can't carry on the way that they're supposed to, because they don't know what's happening.
And you can't assume that somebody just, especially with the multiple lanes, that they're not exiting.
Yeah.
And
I do think that if we use our indicators and create more fluidity on the roundabouts the way that they're meant to be, mm-hmm. We would eliminate a lot of the traffic situation.
And a lot of the accident situations.
Yes.
By indicating. I know particularly the people that live in the eastern districts from Red Bay up and have to use the ones in Prospect. There's mm-hmm. been like the newer one with the Tomlinson roundabout that was that scared me for like weeks. I was like, I'm just avoiding that. I'm just gonna turn right and go to the one by.
I think our most the roundabout that gives us the most accidents still is the Butterfield roundabout here by
A.L.
Thompson's.
It's highly
It's very
high populated. And tricky and people are coming on, going everywhere. So that one, yeah. But and then there's the one by, so just more recently, because I know even with the Kamana Bay one, even though it's three lanes, we've kind of had a little bit more time to get used to that one.
Yeah.
And it's a little bit, again, a little bit different usage. Like I said, the one up by Prospect, by Tomlinson's Roundabout, and then the, I don't even know if that's the correct name for it, but my people let me know that that's what it is. And then the one by Prospect Primary had a change there.
Yes.
So if you're in the outer lane, you have to turn back into the Prospect area.
Yes.
And it used to be that you could go around and come
and off. A lot of people still are trying to take the outer lane to go all the way around into Spot Street area.
Yeah.
So remember that you have to be on the inside lane to go straight forward.
Right. So both of those have had changes.
Because people have been trying to switch in and causing.
Exactly. So take a little time to get familiar with those ones if you're going to be going back into school, if you're going to be using those in the next coming days, because you don't want to find yourself having to zip in and out of traffic or getting into that little opportunity. And that's driving, right? So you're going to have to like squeeze your way in here and there, but you want to make sure you know exactly where you're going and where you're be in the lane you're supposed to be in. All right, PC Powery. Thank you again. Thank you for staying on a little bit longer.
Thank you for having me. Remember to utilize our tip lines as like Lenny reminded me, 949-7999 is our confidential line, or you can send us information through Crime Stoppers as well, and you'll be eligible for a reward on a conviction. So please do let us know. See something, say something.
Absolutely.
Let us know.
All right. Well, I'll let you go before the weather gets too bad outside. Thank you again for coming, and have a fantastic day. And you all, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more Crosstalk after this.
Crosstalk will be back to leading gay man's conversation shortly on Rooster 101.
I'm looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust. My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow, we know. Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust. My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow, we know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. Print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces. Forge Collective.
Good morning, this is Tim Hartman for Compass Media. Here are your top news headlines for Thursday, the 26th of August. Forecasters say a tropical wave sweeping through the Caribbean south of Cayman could develop into a tropical depression or storm, most likely by tomorrow. Cayman Islands National Weather Service warned the system is expected to produce significant rainfall across the Cayman Islands, 1 to 2 inches expected, with flooding most likely to occur on Friday. In a severe weather bulletin issued by the National Weather Service yesterday, forecasters said whether or not the system develops into a tropical depression or stronger, Cayman could expect cloudy and overcast skies, scattered thunderstorms with showers likely to be heavy at times over the next 48 hours. And the Cayman Islands government has revised the date for when it hopes the islands will reach the 80% vaccination rate from the 9th of September to the 14th of October. With the original target date just 2 weeks away, the fully vaccinated rate in Cayman is currently at 69%, a rate that has not increased since the 13th of August. The government's original reopening plan, announced by Premier Wayne Panton in early July, involved a limited return of tourism by the 9th of September when Phase 3 of the plan gets underway, contingent on reaching the 80% goal. Panton, speaking at a press briefing, briefing yesterday said Phase 3 will go ahead as planned, even without reaching the 80% target. He pointed out that when quarantine restrictions for vaccinated tourists are lifted on the 14th of October, Phase 4 of the plan, the risk of community transmission in Cayman will rise exponentially. So to be clear, that next phase will go ahead whether or not we have reached those vaccination numbers. HSA.ky has the latest vaccination schedule. Make sure you're following Hazard Management, the Cayman Islands National Weather Service, also gov.ky for all the updated weather information over the next 24 hours. And for these and other of the nation's news headlines, visit caymancompass.com.
Now back to Cayman Crosstalk. Join the conversation. Call the Crosstalk Hotline, 233-1019. Brought to you by Global Medical Center and Laboratory.
All right, so we had a caller come in over the break, and it was Mr. Walters from the driving. So I'm asking him to call back because we couldn't talk to him while we were playing the news and everything else. So round three, Jody's still here. So he was like, wait, did she leave? I'm like, she was just out the door. But Joel, yeah, so we have him. Hello, caller. Mr. Walters, is that you?
Hello there.
Hi. So you're the driving expert so with the roundabouts, and we had some roundabout conversations. So I know you wanted to weigh in, so I'm just going to leave it open to you.
Okay.
You're live. You can take it away. What was your comments and questions, or what comments did you have to make about the roundabouts and the road safety for us?
Oh, okay. I'm ready for you. You ready for me?
I'm ready for you. Go ahead.
Okay. Catch it. Quick. I'm going to push fast, so listen fast.
All right.
If you plan to leave a roundabout at the first or the second exit, you should stay in the left lane, the outside lane.
Okay.
And if you plan to leave at any more than two exits, you should stay in the inside lane.
Okay.
And you should be indicating to let the other motorists know where you're going.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can't call them on your cell phone and let them know where you're going. You don't have their cell phone number anyway.
Right.
Not only that, if you use a cell phone while you're driving, you're going to get a ticket.
Right. Okay. Good point so far. So when you are coming off, right, and so now with the three-lane ones, where do you find yourself if you're in the middle lane or in the, let's say in the inner lane, and you need to get off? How do you...
You plan to leave at the first or the second exit. You should be in the left outside lane.
Right.
And if you plan to leave at any more than two exits, you should be on the inside lane.
Okay, so if you're on the inside lane of a three-lane situation, right?
Yeah.
Can you change at any point that it's clear to get into the proper lane to exit? So if you're getting off at the second or third and you're in that inner lane, can... As long as there's room for you to maneuver into the next lane, you can go, or do you just have to, you know, you just keep going around if it's not safe?
Indicate, look over your left shoulder, and if it's not safe, you should go around again one more time and wait until it's safe to get out.
Right, and I think that's what people are missing, that it's okay to go back around. You don't have to, like, fight to get off and put yourself in a tricky situation, especially...
If it's not safe, keep going around.
Yeah.
And try in a safe
place. Right. Okay. And I think there's a little bit to be said about familiarizing yourself with some of these roundabouts, because they can be quite tricky and you do have to know where you're going. But yeah, any other further comments that you have for us on the safety?
Bear in mind that signals are languages of the road to warn other motorists of your intention.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't indicate, they will not know what you're doing.
True. True. Absolutely.
Thank you, Mr. Walters.
All right.
So, Mr. Walters, can I hook you up with some lunch from Walk and Roll for calling in and being such a helpful participant this morning?
I welcome that.
All right. Awesome. Can you give me a text me on the WhatsApp number, please?
I will.
It's 324-1019.
All right.
Okay. I will. Thanks so much.
Yeah.
All right. 324. Okay. Have a great day. Bye.
324-1019.
Yes, 324-1019.
Cool.
All right. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Yes, bye. Have a good day.
You too. Bye-bye.
Yeah, so that was my emergency driver instructor when I was in training school.
Okay, way back then.
And
the roads have changed quite a lot since then. So, all right. Okay, so I think we've tortured PC Powery this morning. She's, every time she's about to escape, we're like, no, come back. And she knows, We always try to book her for like a whole hour, and she's like, I don't need all that time. But we're going to make you stay. So anyway, we know she has a busy job. She has a lot out there. There's always things going on. There's another call?
No, he's on the call, same way.
Oh, okay.
He's gone.
Yeah, no, I think he just needed to hang up. All right, we're going to let her go, because I do want to just catch up with the reopening, and I know you guys, even at RCIPS, there is tons of planning and tons of things that you guys even have to get ready and prepared for that, and it's there's always something.
Before I go with all these talks of roundabouts and the roadways, I want to say a shout out to NRA. You know, they're always assisting us with our road safety campaigns and you know, anything at all, keeping us up to date on their road work and making sure that we have safe roads to drive on. So thank you, guys.
Absolutely. I actually had a quick question for them one day. I was driving. My son and I were like, how do you measure the when they're doing the line down the middle? Like, how do you know? Because that's always going to be different depending on where the, like, how wide the road is. And so one day I saw them out there and I just pulled over, and they were quite friendly and nice. And they explained it to me that it's, you know, they have their boundary line. So even if there's a shoulder or a property setback, that they mark it from the middle of the surveyed boundary lines for the road. And I'm like, oh, okay, well, good to know. So especially with all these new roads, like, how do you measure that? All right. Well, PC Power, thank you for coming on. And we'll catch up with you again soon. Have a great day.
Bye.
All right. So guys, I just want to wrap up this this show this morning with the conversation from the premiere and what we were to expect with the reopening, because I know not everybody got the opportunity to be able to watch the full press conference. And I want to talk about it in more detail tomorrow, because there were questions, there were other things that were said after, like, the, you know, some people just watched like the first 15 minutes. All right, what's the highlights? What can we expect? But it was quite a long presser yesterday. It was about 2 hours. And I watched the full thing, went back and took some notes. So there's some more questions that have come up, like what's going to happen after, that I want to talk to you guys about, or what's going to be like causes to shut back down, what's going to happen with risks and public gatherings. So I just want there are some things that we do need to consider, not just the dates. And a lot of it is in the reopening plan. And many of us haven't read the reopening plan in detail. So sometimes hearing this information through the news and other sources is where we're going to get it from. So I just wanted to play that first part of the clip where the premier speaks to what the situation is, just generally, just for anybody who didn't get that. I just want to catch that up for you guys. So, Lenny, do we have that ready now? No, not ready. Okay. So, I'm just gonna give Lenny a couple minutes. But there's a lot of things that are gonna come out of that. So, I'll talk a bit about like herd immunity if we have a chance to today. But we also had Minister Juliana O'Connor Connolly. She gave a very personal testimony about her hesitancy, because she's now recently just been fully vaccinated, and both her and her and Dr. Colin Charles, who we've had on the show as well, shared very personal stories about people in their, like, Dr. Colin Charles has had COVID, so he shared his experience, and then Minister O'Connor Connolly also shared her experiences with having people near to her be exposed and pass from COVID, and how this kind of influenced her decision, the research that she did. So I want to talk about that more tomorrow. I also want to invite you guys tomorrow to call in and tell me if you do have hesitancies, or if you did have a hesitancy in getting the vaccine, what changed your mind? I just want to talk about it, because I think that there's so much information. There's a lot of misinformation. I don't know all of the answers, so I'm not going to sit here and tell you that you have to do it because I did it or that you're wrong for not doing it. I understand it's scary, but I do think it does help when we talk through what some of our situations are, what some of our fears are, and understand where we can go to find the information. So one of the things that I do, and it does irk me a little bit, I understand if you're scared. I totally get that. What I can't completely accept is this thought process that if I was going to have brain surgery done, if I was going to have back surgery done, if I woke up one morning or after weeks of not feeling well, I started to progress, get worse and worse and deteriorate, and I was, you know, having nausea, or I was throwing up and sick for days on end, and I was having severe pains or, you know, headaches and everything else, that if I had to go to a doctor to tell me what was wrong, I would trust that. And maybe I would get a second opinion, right? Fair enough. Might get a second opinion on a diagnosis. But if I had to have surgery, or if I had to be diagnosed, and if I had to have tests run and whatnot, I would trust the science. I would trust the medicine to take care of me. And yet, when it comes to the vaccine, everybody has an opinion that they are now a doctor. So I know we hear people saying that, you know, our government aren't doctors and they can't tell us this and that. But a lot of the doctors are saying that this is okay. So I just want to implore people to not get confused when it comes to matters of common sense. So if you would trust your doctor for certain things, then talk to your doctor and ask them whether this is the right decision for you. You see what I'm saying with that? Like, it just, take the sensible approach. I know there's a lot of information out there. I know we're, you know, it's the human in us and human nature in us to be concerned and to be, you know, to be cautious, especially when it comes to our life. But like I said, if you would trust the science and the medicine in another emergency situation, then go talk to your doctor and understand whether you should trust it in this situation, right? Don't let anybody else tell you what that looks like. Okay, guys, so I'm going to go back to this this clip really quick, and we're going to hear what, just so we just get the premise, so that you know, just in case you didn't have a chance and you're not getting the third-party information, you're going to get it direct from the source. We are going to go ahead and play that clip for you, and then we'll have a quick little discussion afterwards.
To speak to you today, not only as premier of the country, but as a son of the soil, who is deeply concerned about our people, about our country, and about all those who call these shores home. Frankly, I am deeply concerned as to the potential unnecessary loss of life because some in our community still refuse to take the vaccination, which remains one of the most effective tools we have to protect ourselves from the ill effects of the virus, which causes the disease known as COVID-19. I do understand that there is a segment of our community that cannot take the vaccine for a variety of reasons, even religious ones. But for the rest, there is not really any excuse. I want to recognize that we accept that our people have the right to have the views that they have. We don't want to say that we are going to disrespect those views. And one thing is for certain, we don't want to be in a position where we want this issue to be divisive for the country. But I want to say that notwithstanding that, we are going to, as a government, continue to promote the uptake of the vaccine. And as people continue to resist vaccination, I want to say that you're putting yourselves, your families, your neighbors, and indeed our entire country at risk. And I don't think that is right. I've heard a myriad of excuses from people who do not want to take the vaccine, that there are long-term effects, that the vaccine contains computer chips, that people have died, that people have had to have organ transplants, emergency surgery. Ladies and gentlemen, all of these are myths and lies designed to scare you and carry out an anti-vaccination agenda. If any of that was true, the Food and Drug Administration, or FDA, would not have given the Pfizer vaccination full approval on Monday. That's the safe and highly effective vaccine that the United Kingdom has provided to us for free, and that our Health Services Administration has been administering since January. Another excuse that I've heard for not taking the vaccine is that government is waffling, that it is not giving a solid date as to when the borders will reopen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think most people should be familiar with our reopening plan. And the relevant date there is October 14th. That is the date that this government has set to remove all quarantine requirements, essentially reopening our borders. That is what I call our C day, the day or the date that the risk that COVID will become a reality in our country significantly ratchets up. That is the date that we stop relying on our very effective and protective testing and quarantine mechanisms and start relying on the vaccine to keep us safe from serious illness and death. That is the date that those of you who have not been vaccinated will be at an exponentially increasing risk of being in close contact with someone who is carrying COVID. That is the date when there will be the chance that you cross paths with that COVID-carrying visitor at the supermarket, the liquor store, the hardware store, or any restaurant or church, anywhere really. And that you may become infected and, God forbid, take the virus home to your unvaccinated children, grandchildren, at-risk parents, or grandparents. Do you really want to be perceived as being that irresponsible? COVID, ladies and gentlemen, is real, and it is going to be very likely to be present when we open our borders. And we have to understand that community transmission of COVID, which we have been able to successfully limit with the measures we have had in place, will be a much greater possibility. In relation to the vaccine, is it safe? Undoubtedly, yes. Is it guaranteed to prevent infection? No. Is it the best possible protection that we have available to us? Absolutely. So we have the opportunity now to protect ourselves, our families, and our community. What I'm asking you to do, again, as your premier and a son of the soil who loves his people, his country, and those who call Cayman home, is to get vaccinated. We plan to move the requirement for the 80% vaccination target from the 9th of September to the 14th of October. As of today, about 72% of our estimated population of 71,106 people have received their first jab, and about 69% have had both doses. I know that there has been some confusion about population statistics. So using the population figure of 65,786 released by the Economics and Statistics Office last week, close to 78% have received the first shot, and about 75% have received the second. Let me just say, ladies and gentlemen, in relation to that, with the Delta variant, this notion of a target for vaccination is becoming more and more difficult to maintain. It is something that we really need to be seeking to maximize in terms of vaccine distribution and take up, because the Delta variant, as has been indicated fairly recently, has a very high rate of contagion. Its transmissibility is very similar to measles or chickenpox, and we need to have as many people as possible vaccinated. This is a very serious situation that the world is facing. There is the potential for even greater variants with worse transmissibility potential. But this one in particular is something that we have to deal with, and we have to recognize is a very significant risk for us. We will still go into phase three of our reopening on the 9th of September, accepting all fully vaccinated visitors who will still have to quarantine during this slow season. This will help government and the tourism sector develop capacity for dealing with larger volumes of travelers in preparation for high season. But if we want to stick to the 14th of October date of opening with no quarantine, we need to be ready. Ready to accept visitors, ready to expect COVID, and ready to manage it safely. Remember that we have had no community spread of the virus for well over a year. So we will not have much natural immunity from infections, making vaccinations all the more crucial. In my heart of hearts, all isn't doom and gloom yet. We still have time. I believe we can work together to get the 80% vaccination ratio by October, or hopefully even exceed it. The target that we have set, we believe, based on the scientific evidence, will help us have the best chance of limiting community transmission and the most devastating impacts of COVID.
All right, guys. So that I'm going to leave it at that today, because, like I said, it's a very long press conference, but I just wanted you to get the summary of where they're coming from with these reopening dates, hear a little bit about the targets. I'm still a little bit lost on what our target number is, whether it's the 65,786 that the ESO just released. Are we still looking for that 71,000 higher number? So I'm a little confused on that. So I do want to dedicate some time tomorrow morning to talk a little bit more about this. And I'm going to recap when we come back. I'm just going to take a quick break, and then I'll just do some recaps as to what I've heard in terms of what we can expect in the coming weeks, because this isn't a lot of time, guys. It's weeks. So September is right upon us. September starts next week, and we have flown through August. I remember saying, boy, August got here quick, and now August has left just as quickly as it came. So I'm going to take a quick break, and I just want to highlight a couple things and let you know what we'll be talking about tomorrow. All right, so stay tuned. Be right back with more Crosstalk.
Crosstalk will be back to leading gay man's conversation shortly on Rooster 101.
Looking for a new pizza joint with that perfect crust? My car needs a bit of a tune-up, and my pregnant wife needs something from the pharmacy. So I turned to the printed yellow directory, and in an instant, the pizzas are ordered, the oil change is booked, and the thing that I'm not allowed to say out loud has been purchased for my wife. Problem solved. When you need something quick, do yourself a favor. Flip through the printed Yellow directory. Stop searching, start finding. Yellow, we know local.
When it comes to bringing your vision to life, our team of designers here at Compass Print are here to help. Whether it's business cards, wedding invitations, flyers, or programs, we got you covered. We've expanded our custom print services, which allows us to perform quick turnarounds along with unique print projects never seen in the Cayman Islands. Our brand new jet varnish printer that allows us to perform a wide variety of varnish and embellishment projects. Print with reflective foils, tangible textures, and glossy surfaces. Forge collectibles, not lifeless paper. Create memories, not nuisances. Raise the standard of old print designs and eliminate the hassle of overseas services. Contact us today. Email us at printshop@compassmedia.ky or call 949-5111 for more details.
Cold case. It's a phrase no investigator likes to...
Conversation. Be a part of the conversation now. Call 233-1019.
All right, guys, so just to wrap up, we just have a couple minutes left here. The grand reopening date that we are looking as a target for is the 14th of October. There was also later on in the press conference, they said as we start this, enter into phase three now, which is expected on the 9th of September, that where they're going to still let in fully vaxxed visitors to quarantine. We're going to see things. We're going to see the flights reopening. This is the soft launch of the reopening process with the main date of October 14th. But in between now and then, like around the beginning of October, they said that they will, you know, update us as to what's happening that first week. So I'll talk about that a little bit more, as well as some of the questions of if we do have clusters, if we do have spikes, if the country starts to become overwhelmed, which we've seen other countries, seen that happen to other countries, what's the plan? What are we going to do? So all of that's there. And I, like I said, do want to talk about it, as well as I want to hear from you guys. Part of what was said was that there's still a lot of questions, sometimes more questions than answers, and if we can actually just talk to people, and this is part of what Minister O'Connor Connolly said, that, like, you know, it was just talking through some of the process. Even after she had done extensive research, her human nature was still kind of nervous to embark down this road, and even though she talked to her doctors and everything, she was still a little bit hesitant, and it was having those conversations and with friends, family members, even the premier, that got her through making the decision for herself. So I think it's just important that we talk about it. So if you do have hesitancies, if there's things that you want answers to, please let us know. Call me tomorrow. I'll make some time in the morning that we can talk about what are some of the public hesitations. What would you like to have a little bit more guidance or understanding about? All right. Also, just remember, we have the severe weather alert, so make sure you're prepared on that note. We did have a message from Mr. Quincy Brown. So he's in Kingston. He said he's good morning, tuned in from Kingston, Jamaica. And he said, Cayman, you can expect lots of rain, because there's lots of rain here in Jamaica. So, you know, we have our feelers out there all over the world. So thanks so much, Quincy, for letting us know what we can expect. And you heard it right there. Also, just before we go, want to remind you guys that just wanted to make an announcement that there was a missing dog out there. Somebody just asked me to post that, if we could possibly just let you know that Maggie is missing right now, last seen in Boatswain Bay on the 25th of August on Wednesday morning. Friendly and responsive, no collar or microchip, and she weighs about 40 to 50 pounds. Looks like mixed breed, and what would you call this color? Tan and white. So a sandy colored dog. Her name is Maggie. So if you see her around, please call 927-2537 or 324-0706. And I've posted that up on our social media stories as well. So please be on the lookout for this missing dog. All right, guys. So that's it. Tomorrow we're going to be talking more about some of this more about the COVID, talk a little about what herd immunity means. I'll see if I can get these answers on what is the exact population figure we are looking at for this 80% and where we're at with that. So we'll just spend some time on that in the morning, first part of the morning, and then at 8 o'clock, I have asked Ms. Ruthanna Young to come in and talk to us about the real estate market. You've been seeing in the Cayman Compass that we've had a housing series going on about affordable housing, about housing situations where people are living in substandard situations. So I've asked Ruthanna to come in. She does a wonderful report on like the real estate market on her social media, and she has some suggestions about how young Caymanians, how new property owners can get themselves back into get themselves into the market or back into the market. Suppose, you know, maybe you had a little bit of a hitch and you had to sell your property and you need to get back in there. So looking forward to talking to her tomorrow morning, and I will see you guys there. Be safe on the road. Have a great day, and don't stress too much. And I'll see you right back here early tomorrow morning for more Crosstalk. This is Chanda V signing out.
This is Reba McIntyre.
Mitchell Timpani here.
This is Miranda Lambert.
This is Gay Man Country. Rooster 101 Georgetown. Owned and operated by Compass Media. And broadcasting live to the most beautiful place on earth, Grand Cayman.
Going down like a sunset, burning out like a cigarette, blowing through.